So guys, this good night. This is the Witness Without Identity YouTube channel. This channel is dedicated to a certain group of people that are both on the left and the right in the political world, but it's also dedicated for people that are trying to find themselves in the midst of this world. This world is filled with problems and conflicts and obstacles that we have to overcome. That's what it's about. It's always about this, and I'm encouraging in this channel to learn to witness without using our identity, to be able to transcend everything that's happening. It's a very interesting channel. So basically, here we have a topic about Trump. Trump is has he said that in his channel, he said that in his press conference that maybe we can use disinfectant, the Clorox or things like Clorox disinfectant to kill the virus, because you can kill the virus with a disinfectant on a hard surface, right? Exterior, like, okay, so you use it on a table on a hard surface, you can kill the virus like that. He's suggesting that maybe we can use it inside our body, and heat and ultraviolet light, maybe we can use it inside the body. The doctors did not say that. The doctors only say, probably the scientists only say, yes, disinfectant kill the virus on the outside. Yes, it does that. It kills the virus on a hard surface. But me, I thought we know this already. But I don't know. I thought we know this. That's why we were using Clorox. And you can use disinfectant on a hard surface. We can use, of course, a very hot light, like, or even the sun. The sun can kill the virus. The virus is not difficult to kill. The problem with the virus is when it gets inside your body, it causes damage because now you cannot catch it. It's inside your body, and it's a tough thing. It's tough to kill it then. That's the environment that the virus can live and cause a lot of damage. But in outside in the world, nothing. There's nothing to be afraid because you're killing the virus without anything else. The virus wants to attach itself to an organism like human, the human organism, and once it's in there, that's it. It can cause a lot of damage. Depends on the person, of course. But Trump, he got involved in the science of it, and he suggested to the doctor to look into see if we can put disinfectant inside human body, and that did not go well. I mean, it made Trump look very stupid for saying something like this, because who's gonna say something like this? I mean, come on, even a little kid can know that. And even if you thought that you could do that, you would have asked the scientists first inside your closet, hey, can we do that? Then maybe you can bring it to the podium in front of a camera. But the guy doesn't care. He has no shame. And that's the thing about Trump. I see that about Trump. Some people don't understand that. Trump has no shame. He's not embarrassed. And I see some people, they're trying to diss him, they're trying to hurt him. Many people trying to say that he's stupid. Everybody's trying to disrespect him, but the guy has no shame, so you cannot hurt him. And I see the same thing with Ivanka and with Don Jr. It's something good to have, guys. I'm going to tell you why it's good to have that kind of personality, to have that kind of character in you, because it's like you're not letting people, like, when, let's say somebody says something to you, who are they saying the thing to? They're saying it to your identity. They are attacking your identity. Nobody, when they attack you, attack the self. The self cannot be attacked. The self is invisible and eternal. You cannot attack it, and you cannot even say, even if you were to say something bad about the self, it doesn't make sense because the self has no, it's not an object. You see, it's there. It just sees. And even the one that says it has a self that is just like yourself. You see, the inner consciousness is universal. It's inside everybody. So if somebody say, "Hey, you suck," whatever, it's saying it to your identity. It's not saying it to the inner being, the inner consciousness. So this is where God resides, or the ultimate reality resides. So that's what I want to say. But what I want to focus on right now is what Trump, what's going on with the Trump, what he suggested on the press conference. Let's think about it carefully. He's saying that, like, hey, we can use those things. He's saying that we can use the light inside. The thing about Trump is, like, he's always looking to look smart, even in topics that he doesn't know nothing about. That's the problem with him. And he has to stop doing that. You know, it's not every day that you have to shine. Sometimes you don't shine, sometimes you stay quiet. Look at another thing, right? This podcast video, I mean, this YouTube channel is about being quiet and staying with the self quietly. That's what you should do. Hey, if you don't know something, just stay with yourself and be quiet and listen to the doctors bring their evidence. But he doesn't want to be quiet. He has to say something. So here he's saying that, hey, the reason why he does this is because he thinks that the doctor is going to come up with Clorox and tell us eventually, hey, you can drink Clorox. He believes that the doctor is going to come out and say that eventually, oh, we found out, oh, we tested it, guys, you can now drink Clorox to kill the virus. And Trump's going to say, you know what, I was the first one that said it. I was the first one. That's what he's trying to do. He's trying to, like how you call that, sidestep or like step forward before the scientists and the crowd and claim that, hey, I'm the great scientist. You know, I said it first. You can drink Clorox to kill yourself, to kill the virus, which is going to kill yourself. And basically, it is going to kill the virus. It is true. If you do drink Clorox, you're going to die and the virus is going to die. But I don't think that's what we want. You know, so that's the danger about Trump. It's like, we have to be careful. He has to be careful what he says it. But the media is playing a game that is a little bit different. They're saying, like, some people in the media are saying that Trump is suggesting that we should go ahead and drink Clorox. He's not suggesting that. He's suggesting that the scientists should research more on this. There's a big difference. We see, because this channel is about reality and being true, we're going to stay true. And I'm not even a big, like, in my being, I'm not, in myself, my ego self, I'm not even a big fan of Trump. But I want to be real to him and I want to be fair to him. He said, specifically, that you can research on it. The scientists can research on it. He did not give the green light for people to start drinking Clorox. You see, but some people are going to say that. And it does sound like that. And it is irresponsible from Trump to say that. Because many people might take it like that. That's why Trump is so stupid. The same thing he did with Hillary. When he said that, if she got to elect her judges, nothing we can do, folks. And the Second Amendment, he talked about the Second Amendment people, maybe they are the only one that can do something. Maybe they can take her out. You know, like they can assassinate her. And so Trump has a very dangerous rhetoric. And we have to watch him. I think Trump should stay away from this thing, but like from the press conference, because this is getting too intense now, and we don't have time to waste with what Trump has to say. There's nothing that he brings to the table that's like valuable. But maybe we want him. I mean, maybe some people, like if you're on the left and you want Trump to lose, maybe you want him to go to the conference and talk more. Maybe that, you know what I'm saying? I think we're making a mistake by saying that Trump, we don't want Trump to talk more. I've seen people on the left say that we don't want to hear from him. I think we want to hear from him because he might say some great things that might totally destroy his election. And then now the Democrat might win. Because this thing he just said, if he was just silent, that wouldn't be good for the Democrat. It's good that Trump is saying those things. It's very good, like, you know, for the Democrat, for him to say, hey, we should drink Clorox, so that we can, the Democrats can show to the country that, you see, the Republican Party and Trump, those are crazy people. Now they're telling us to drink Clorox. Come on. And he's a president. The guy's a freaking president. And there's a pandemic. People are dying all over the place. And he's talking about for us to drink Clorox. So that's too much for us to handle. So basically, that's the way I look at Trump. Trump has to, that's the way I look at it. The left and the right, they have to allow Trump to talk. Because when he talks, he might give the left an opportunity to win. Because Trump is very popular with his people. So Trump is not going to be an easy guy to beat. So I think the best way to beat Trump, for me, in my hand, is to let him talk. But Trump, as far as him, if I was on his side, I would tell him to shut up. Let's not talk about the virus, because you know nothing about it. Let the scientists talk. And they come out and say and repeat exactly what the scientist said. Like, for example, if the scientist said something that is real, even if you don't like it, that's what it is. I think Dr. Fauci said that the virus still is going to be there in the fall. And there might be a second wave. Trump doesn't want to hear that. But that's the reality. It's a tough thing, but it's real. I think we're gonna have to go back to work, but we're gonna wear the mask. Everybody's gonna have, like, you know, hand sanitizer. I think that's what's gonna happen. We cannot last like that for a year and a half. We're gonna go back to work, but we're gonna be ready. Like, places like California, they're definitely gonna have to go back to work. But we're gonna have hand sanitizer, stuff like that, and then we're gonna wear the mask. I mean, that's the way I look at it. Guys, I wanna thank you guys for listening to my channel. Remember that every issue that happened in your life, both in the world, or even in your personal life, family issues, they are all the same. They are very conflicting, and sometimes they are issues that are difficult to digest. The best way to do this is to be quiet and to go in on the inside, where you see everything on the outside, and you stay quiet as the almost close to, almost as the number zero. Be the number zero, where you're not attached to anything. No political party, not your family, you're not against this or for this. You listen to the person, you listen to the conflict as a hawk. You listen carefully. And out of that, there's going to come out a solution, a something. It's going to be something that you're going to be very satisfied with. It's not going to be angry, it's not going to be confused. And it's going to be that, it's almost like it's going to be the answer that God wants you to have. And I'm going to say something else, guys. Just the fact that I have an opinion, and I bring my opinion from my quiet self, from my very calm self, that does not mean that my opinion is the universal opinion, that it is the right one. It's just that what I feel comfortable. And you might bring an opinion, and then we might have a discussion, but both of us have a beautiful discussion, and we don't hate each other, even though you're on the opposite side. That's what I'm pushing for us to have great discussion, for us to be able to resolve our issues. And the place we can do that is to go back to the zero. Go back to the zero self and be quiet. And then bring the issue one at a time, very, very, very systematically and very carefully, slowly and carefully. And don't allow the emotion and the ego to get involved, where you can get angry. Don't get angry. And that's it. And everything should be resolved. Because you are in the place of God, and peace on earth will reside, will prevail. Peace on earth will prevail if we do this. You know, there will be no more war. You know, there will be no more conflict between left and right, Republican and Democrats. So that's what I'm pushing for. And if you believe in my message, I'm asking you to please subscribe to my channel. Subscribe to my channel. Let other people know about my channel. We have to grow this channel, because when we look at the world, there's confusion. You see, like the thing that Trump said, look at what he said, right? About the virus thing, to drink Clorox. We are so, the party are so separated, and they are fighting at each other like tooth and nail, that the people on the white are gonna defend Trump. They're gonna say, oh, Trump did not say that. Oh, Trump, he was laughing, he was joking. They're gonna find a way to hide behind it. You know why it's like that? Because we do not meet at a concrete or the normal place where we can judge things carefully and normally. Well, if you are, the reason why those people are saying that is because they are so identified with the Republican Party, and they are so into that party that they feel that they have to defend that guy. That's my party, that's who I am, that's my identity. After my identity, I'm nobody. There are people like that. You can see people like that. There are people like that in the world. If I don't have that identity, I'm no longer, I don't longer exist, and that's not true. So I'm pushing my view into this world into the most divisive world, in the world of politics, and I'm hoping that I can bless people as I'm talking. I'm hoping that, you know, this message can really get inside the human consciousness, and we can see that, hey, we don't have to fight like that. There's no reason to fight. Let's be quiet. Let's be calm. And after we debate our issues, we can go home and go to bed. And we don't have to be crazy about black or white, Chinese or white, and then Republican or Democrats. Let's calm down. All right, guys, thank you. It was nice doing this video with you. Thank you, bye.